Let me.
Chicago police continue to search for a missing school teacher. Deborah Ann Skokie, last seen on Tuesday leaving her Ashburn residence to meet friends and has not been seen since. Police request that...
A police department spokeswoman has announced the formation of a special unit task force in conjunction with the FBI to investigate the recent Chicago
area. I'm standing outside the Chicago Police Department where moments ago, detectives announced they've taken Francis Allen Visser into custody. Visser has been a person of interest in the murder of Irene Berg and Katie Salvage, whose bodies were found buried not far from a popular hiking trail near Black Rock Park.
In a shocking development today, Francis Allen Visser, a suspect in the terrifying burial murders of several young women in the Chicago area, was released from custody this morning. There is speculation that lead investigator Detective Thomas McCormick may be facing disciplinary action for the possible tampering of evidence found at the scene of the crime. A spokesperson from Internal Affairs has stated, "We are no longer pursuing Mr. Visser at this point in the investigation." When asked if he would file suit against the Chicago Police Department, his attorney stated, "No, he just wants his old life back." Detective McCormick declined to comment. A press conference is scheduled for later today.
How many times do I have to tell you to clean out your station?
Gone, Eugene.
Use your head tonight, son.
Come on, Gene, baby. It's Friday night. Ladies are waiting, and I already got my shit worked up.
Please, don't use that kind of language. You might impress your friends with talk like that, but man's legacy is all he has.
Gene. When are you going to even have that razor?
Well, I said I would, Luis. When I see you're careful with what you leave behind.
You're my dad, Eugene. You know what, man? You need to get out. Something. I mean, it wouldn't kill you to come hang out, man. Drink a beer. Find yourself a little mamacita. Get your little dance on.
You know how I feel about that.
Come on.
Alcohol says something about a man before he gets a chance to say anything about himself.
I know. Says he's having fun. On that note, peace out.
how you doing?
Hey, Eugene, come here once.
Hey, Davey.
Davey over here right now was just saying that with a haircut, I would look younger.
Well, you know, it's a barbershop, Chief, not a time machine.
Hey, Gene, you know, I really appreciate what you're doing. You know, taking interest in Louise like that.
Train a child up in the way of the Lord, and he won't depart from it.
Yeah. And when he does, he'll get my help in hand.
You come by anytime, Chief.
Right.
Get those ears lowered.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Howdy, Mr. Vito.
All right, thanks.
Working nights this week. You know, I got that long drive back to Brule. Should have went to college, you know? Like, I don't know what you want.
Okay, then. Good enough.
Hi.
Snuck in on me.
Uh-huh.
Can I get you some coffee?
You know, I never really liked coffee. What else you got?
Some good things on that menu. Have you taken a look?
I haven't.
What are you in the mood for?
Something sweet.
Stay here. I'll surprise you.
You know, you're taller than I thought. Older, too, but I bet you can still handle your shit if you had to, right?
Do I know you?
Eugene Van Winger, the barber.
Yeah?
That's not your real name, though, is it, Mr. Fissick?
Your mistake.
Damn! The poise on you. Look, I know they had to kick you loose. Lack of evidence, no witnesses, no fingerprints, nothing. 17 bodies, that's a lot to walk away from.
Excuse me.
Oh, come on, Mr. V-Dub. Oh, oh. Chicago PD wouldn't let you live it down. Had you pegged a murderer? God, I bet it was real tough trying to buy groceries after your face had been plastered all over the
place. I'll give you whatever you want. Please, please don't kill me.
Kill you? I don't want to kill you. I'm trying to impress you.
Impressed?
Jay! Are you okay? Stop! Freeze!
You got no ID? And this name you gave me, John D. LaRue, well, you know, that just doesn't show up anywhere. Nowhere. I mean, it's not in the DMV, not in Social Security, not in the library system.
I look like I got a fucking library card.
Oh, no. Looks like you're giving me a false name. So, when'd you get into town?
Okay.
You know, I'm not some rube from the sticks, asshole. I'm Kenosha PD, 12 years.
Holy shit, Kenosha.
Yeah.
Is this a promotion?
Okay.
So tell me a story. Tell me the one about the guy outside of Heidebrecht's, the guy you poked with that.
I thought I knew him.
And who was that? The guy you thought you knew?
My old man. Fucker up and left when I was a kid. Guy in the diner, spitting fucking image. Followed him out, asked him his name. The guy freaks his shit.
And so you thought you'd get some blood for a paternity test? Yeah. Well, the guy you poked with that, he's a real good friend of mine. So I need to know why his blood's on your fucking knife.
Daddy likes it rough.
Chief, Eugene's out front.
G,
Gene, are you okay? I mean, we've been calling.
I'm fine. Man, oh, man, I must have made a spectacle of myself. Running away like that.
Yeah, yeah, we were worried about you. You get anyone to look at that for you?
No, it's nothing. The fellow you brought in, did he say anything?
Oh, he spouted some bunk story.
What story?
He thought you were his father. It's bullshit. This kid, he'll say anything.
I want you to let him go. I mean, he didn't hurt me.
Well, he stuck a knife in you, Gene. No, no more charity cases. Wait. Is he yours?
I'm not going to press charges.
You don't have to press charges.
Gary, we've been friends a long time. I never asked for a favor. I'm asking for one now. Please let the kid go. Please.
You got a problem, man?
Get in the truck.
Am I gonna be number 18?
Get in the truck.
Okay.
Great dump site. Isolated off the highway. This is yours? Bring me out here to show me?
I told the chief of police you thought I was your father. What's wrong with you?
That loyal prick thinks you're a saint.
Why would you say that?
Cops liked you for a bunch of those missing girls, right? But they couldn't make it stick. My favorites were the ones you put in the ground.
I've never been involved in any kind of violence.
Come on. Scratch marks on those pine lids. I want to know how you picked them. What's the trigger? What's the thing? It goes click in your head. This one, not that one. Debbie Ann Skokie, you're first.
If I am who you think I am, why wouldn't I just kill you right now and bury you up here where nobody would ever find you? I'm not who you think I am. I'm not, so please stop this. Please.
Mr. Visser, I know who you are because I'm your biggest fan. I get it. You're laying low. You're taking a break. But I know that that itch doesn't die. I know. I live with it. And if I'm going to learn anything about who I am and what I am, it's going to be from you. I mean, with your experience, because you and me, we are the same. I looked for you everywhere for so long.
What happened in Chicago was a horrible mistake. They let me go.
They let you go because you're the best.
They let me go because they had the wrong man. It's cold. Go down the hill to the highway. I wait too. Someone will pick you up. You leave me alone.
You brought me here to leave me? What the fuck are you doing? Get the fuck out of the car.
Visser! Visser!
What the fuck?
It's a Monday morning.
Dragging me down, but I think it's just a little late.
Have another drink.
Hitman, you okay?
Kelly, right?
Yeah. I saw you get arrested back there. That sucks.
Yeah, right.
Do you want to use my phone? Do you need to call somebody?
Take a ride into town if you could.
Yeah, come on.
I've been trying to leave this bank-ass town for like 2 years now. A place like this, they notice everything. They stare at me like I'm a freak. I just want to move to the city, you know? Be anonymous. I guess I just need somebody to kick me in my big old butt.
Do you always take this highway home?
Yep. There's no cops. I speed.
During the middle of my session.
$40 and we'll find out.
Come on.
Hey. We have a strict touch and go policy.
You touch, I go. That's the point.
Okay. I got something special for a special fella like you. CPD, motherfucker. You're under arrest.
Okay. You went through my shit?
I didn't go through your shit. Mm-hmm. They were sitting right on top. I grabbed them. Sit down with me.
Nod your head if you think this was fucking stupid.
Man, I just gave you a ride. We're cool, right?
Stranger. Motel. Middle of the night. The fuck did you think was gonna happen?
What? Who is this?
You would have done it better, right? I mean, of course you would. I know I made a mess. I got a little sloppy, but I mean, I passed your test, right?
What test?
You told me go down the highway, someone will pick you up. You said, take highway 2. You said that, right? You said that. You're trying to tell me that, you knew she'd be out there, and you knew that I would find her, and you put me in the perfect fucking spot, right? Right? Trust me. Why would you? I just showed up out of the blue, threatened you. Yeah, why would you tell me the deepest and darkest? Unless I got a rope around my neck too, right? Well, now I do. Leave me in the woods like that? That was fucking brilliant. You wanted to see if I wanted it, right?
What do you want from me?
I know there's more. Like, there's something else. There's something that I can't come up with on my own. I know you know what I'm talking about.
Who saw you come in?
What? No, nobody.
Grace, the manager.
Nobody fucking saw me.
Never use that kind of language. I don't want to hear it out of your mouth. Can you take care of this?
You mean like to get rid of the body?
Can you get it squared away?
Yes, sir. No problem.
Come by the shop tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
a good look for you.
Best haircut I never paid for.
It's always a pleasure, sir.
Well, next time I'm getting a mohawk.
I don't think I remember how to do those things. Be careful out there.
Yeah, you be good.
Okay.
What's up, he pay you this time?
Chief risks his life every day. Haircut's the least I can do.
Cheap ass fucker.
There you go again.
Yo, yo! What's up, man? Welcome. You need a cut? Yours, Eugene? Come on, man, because if he's walking, I gotta get paid. What's up, baby? I got you right here, bro.
I'm here for Eugene.
He's mine.
Man, that's bullshit. Come on.
Hey, Louise, do me a favor. Go over to Heidelberg's, get me a cup of coffee.
Excuse me?
And get one for my client, too.
Black.
Yeah. I'm gonna go wash your goddamn truck while I'm at it.
What did you just say?
Oh, Gene. I mean, who died and made me a fucking slave, man?
Shut your filthy mouth.
Jeez, calm down, man. Whatever.
No, no, not whatever, not whatever. The answer is yes, sir, Mr. Van Wingert. I am your boss in this place of business.
Maybe you should just get the coffee.
Maybe you should shut the fuck up.
That's it. Get out of my...
No, hold on, man.
You got a foul mouth. I'm tired of hearing it.
Look, I'm sorry.
No.
Mr. Van Wingert, I'm sorry, okay?
You had your chance.
Look, you know we got a bad temper.
No,
man. Come on.
No, you had your chance. No.
Seriously?
Yeah. Why do you let yourself look like that?
What? What do you mean?
You look like a bum. I'm not saying dressed to the nines either. A man's appearance should always show self-respect, never self-importance. Hmm.
That's how you stayed under the radar.
I'm trying to tell you how a man should live his life. Be clean, don't rush, that leads to mistakes, and pay attention to the details. Gene Van Wingert, pleasure.
John LaRue.
School starts tomorrow, son.
Hey, Cap.
Aw, oh, shit, Bennett. I'm late for my grandkids' birthday party.
John's gone looking for a man named Francis A. Visser. He's going by Eugene Van Wingert now. He's working as a barber out in Moraine. The same guy that you and his father arrested.
I know who Visser is.
And Thomas McCormack?
Tom is a great detective. The best man I ever knew. But he got obsessed with this Visser case. He worked 24-7 and drank himself sick. And this McCormack Jr., I'm pretty sure he's in that same brain lock.
Well, maybe John found something new. He's convinced the man is guilty.
So was his pops. Tom's cop gut ended up convinced he always brought in the right guy. He became the worst cop possible. He went so deep into that darkness, they'd never see the light again. You know what he did? He shot himself in the fucking head.
John said he was killed in the line.
Yeah, well, I guess our boy has the distorted view of the past, doesn't he?
No, I need to bring him back.
He's off the fucking payroll. He's off the goddamn reservation. He's a loose cannon. Okay, I know that he had a rough time, but he has made his choice, Audrey. And if you go after him, then you're off my ranks, too. That's the way it is, kid.
Last bell's rung. Tardy.
How'd you get in here?
Oh, Grace, the manager. We go to the same church. Where'd you get that?
This from a cop.
He gave it to you?
Yeah, he fucking gave it to me.
Grace saw you leave with Kelly, Mr. Smartmouth.
Really?
No more smoking.
Well, you never had a bad habit?
Listen. Everywhere you go, you're leaving puzzle pieces for anyone who's looking. Up and at 'em, Slugabed. We're going shopping for school clothes.
Have I told you I have a keen interest in birds? They're such delicate creatures. See that little birdie over there? Been watching her for quite a while. I followed her so many times. We've been as close as this.
Size 16, right?
Yep. Thanks a bunch. Mm-hmm. She don't recognize me. She thinks she only knows me from here in the store. I want you to follow her. And then I want you to kill her.
Forget it.
Listen, listen to me.
I already passed this test.
In your mind, count how many times you could have done it. And don't make something up. I know where she goes and what she does. Show me you can be white noise. You do that, and I'll tell you how I got Debbie Ann to eat out of my hand. She's off it too.
That sliding door.
Test's over.
You'd be surprised what people don't see. I mean, they just never consider there's somebody out there watching.
Mm-hmm.
I get close and wait for that one unguarded moment. Debbie Ann. Demi Ann was easy to notice. I watched her for weeks, just thinking about the whole thing, just dreaming about doing it. Mm. And I see this pretty, yummy girl. Thin red lips, thin line between white trash and whore. And I think everything's easy for her. And it just filled me with rage and lust. When I was done, when I finished, I left her Bible open to Hebrews 9:22. There can be no forgiveness without the shedding of blood. It's not too original, but I got better.
You never forget your first, huh?
Or your last. Great work with Judy Lynn today. Tomorrow's my day off. Got another field trip in mind. How many truck stops do we have in this country? Thousands. And every one of them crawling with ungodly yummies.
This is the insider info that you're giving out?
Nope. I'm trying to show you the watch trick.
The what?
The watch trick. See, now looky here. That little birdie has just come off a long shift. All she wants is to get home, put on some sweats, and watch a little reality TV with her cat. It's raining like crazy. You pull up, ask her if she'd like a ride home, or at least somewhere out of the rain. She knows she shouldn't. She'll want to say, no, thank you. And that's when you do this.
That's the watch trick?
You're late. You got places to go. You just stopped out of the kindness of your heart to get her out of the rain.
Who'd you use this on?
No more out of me till I see you get that girl into this truck.
Hi.
Hey.
You look like you want to get out of the rain. You want to ride somewhere dry?
No, it's cool. One of my friends is going to come get me.
That's kind of why I stopped. I barely got through. They closed the road down because of the rain.
Shit.
Come on, you're getting soaked.
No, it's fine. Thank you.
Okay.
Wait, are you sure you don't mind?
Yeah. No, really, I don't. It's not a big deal.
Okay, thanks. Coffee's from those fellas.
You said black, right? Is that right, bro? But you ain't saying anything now, huh?
You got your fucking right here, man. Tell you something, bro. You see, I've been pushing a broom 2 years over there. You know, laughing at his fucking jokes and shit. What, you appearing out of nowhere? And suddenly I'm on the outside looking in. Oh, fuck that, man. I'm in line for that shot.
Hey,
fuck you gonna do, huh? I know you got me fired, right, bitch? You ain't doing shit, man. You a pussy. That's right. Look at these motherfuckers, don't fuck your ass up right now. What you gonna do?
Being tough with all your boys,
yeah,
huh?
That's right.
What the fuck are you looking at?
to it. Fucking adorable, by the way.
Where are you going, bro?
Thank you so much. We're gonna take a piss. You wanna shake it for me, you little faggot?
That's right. Walk away, baby. Walk away. Look at this shit. Punk ass. Sorry about that.
Wingers.
I knew you'd be there this early.
Y'all ran into your boy last night.
I swear, if you heard him.
Look, nothing happened, okay? But I found something on him, man.
I don't have time for this, Luis.
Please, man, look, he's not who he says he is. Look, the last thing we want is for you to be taken advantage of, man.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I can come by and show you, Mr. Van Winger.
1 hour.
Cool.
Say goodbye to me last night.
Fuck you, man.
Oh, fuck me?
You listening yet?
You see this? You're not gonna tell anybody about this. Not your homies, not Eugene, nobody.
You know what? I don't fucking believe you. I know you're tight. You say one thing when you claim a victim and another thing when you get back to the crib. Maybe you're just forgetful. I don't know.
I don't know, but you know what? It makes me fucking sick.
No.
So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna leave you with something that you won't forget.
No, no. I swear to God.
Shut the fuck up. You ready?
You believe a word about me, and I will cut your tongue from your mouth, and I will fucking feed it to you. You got me.
I got you, man.
Are you sure?
Please.
Are you sure?
I swear to God, man. I got you. Please. I got you, man. I got you.
So you fucking remember?
I promise, man. I swear.
Fuck you.
mister. Do you know if this is the way to the Vagabond? I'm totally turned around.
Well, you sure are. It's east about a mile and a half. Want a lift?
Oh, no, it's okay. I don't mind the walk. Thanks, though.
Come on. I'm headed that way.
Really? It's okay.
Suit yourself.
Sure it's cool, Tiger?
No trouble at all. You should wear your seatbelt.
Thanks.
Yeah. Can't be too careful.
Thanks for picking me up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know anyone here. I sure don't mind making new friends, though. You get lonely out here. Where are we going?
No shortcut.
You know, we don't have to go straight to the motel. We can go wherever you want. And I'll make you come real fast.
Today is your lucky day, young lady.
And why is that?
Because I picked you up.
Well, let's get lucky then, Tiger.
You listen to me. You're a pretty girl, and this is a nice town, but that don't mean bad people don't live here. You really should be more careful. Okay? Like you had a fight with a grain thresher. Luis have anything to do with this?
Why would he?
Is there something you should be telling me, John?
What did he say?
That he had something to show me. Know what that was?
Luis is full of shit, Eugene. If he really had something to show you, why didn't he show up this morning?
Why would he say those things?
He thinks that I'm here trying to steal his job. Did he tell you that? No. Right? See, I have been on the up and up with you since day one.
How'd you do in the fight?
I held my own.
Can you drive?
Yeah.
You'll come to my place tonight. You can't take care of yourself here.
No. I'm good. You don't have to do that.
No, I won't take no for an answer. I've got a vacant room in a big old house with nothing but dandelions and dust bunnies taking up precedence.
Oh, no, don't worry. I'll grab my stuff. It's okay, really.
Let's go by the shop and get you cleaned up first. You become like a son to me. Have a seat. Did your father ever teach you how to shave? It's one of the few lessons in life reserved exclusively for sons. You never watched him?
He wasn't really around.
Preparation is very important in shaving, son. The lather should always be thick, never foamy, and always go on light, never heavy.
You
sure you want to get into this?
I'm here, aren't I?
Yeah, yeah. All right. There's this detective once who got in his head. I was the guy for a case he was working. Couldn't let it go. Head back. So one day, he shows up out of nowhere, hauls me in, starts grilling me about some phone calls. Apparently, this detective had been getting calls from some phantom caller claiming he'd abducted a woman, buried her alive. Relax your face. So he showed me the transcripts of these calls, right? See how I'd react to them. And this guy would say things like, I took another one, Tom. Told her not to panic. If she stays calm, you have at least 2 hours. Every time another girl went missing, he'd get another call and just go into this frenzy, trying to piece together clues before it was too late. This guy would ask him, is that enough time? You have all the time you need. I never seen anyone so angry. And there was this one thing I'll never forget. He says, you lost another one, Tom. You never could figure out how to put your ear to the ground and really listen. And the girls, they never really could stay calm. I guess they went back and forth like that until this cop couldn't take it anymore. He knew there was something odd about me. And I told him I didn't know anything about the calls or the girls, but he didn't believe me. He was so sure. Of course, they had nothing hard on me and had to release me. By that time, some photographer had made me famous. That was when I decided to move up here, start over, fresh, out with the old and in with the new. Would you look at that? There's a handsome young man under there. You know, there are a few things that a man needs in life. And a good razor is one of them.
No, I can't take that.
Please.
No, really.
Please. I really want you to.
Thank you, Eugene.
Don't mention it. So, it's not the Ritz. It's home.
Wow.
It's just some stuff I had. Stuff I saved.
Mm-hmm. You hungry?
No. Thank you.
Need anything? Glass of water.
Only thing I need is what you keep not giving me.
Well, then, maybe you should boil it down to what it really is you're looking for.
They arrested you, turned you upside down, and you still walked away. That's it. That's all I'm after. I need you to teach me how to get away with it.
Okay. But not until you get some rest. No.
Okay.
John, I'm really glad you're here. Here for Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Gene? I need to talk to the chief.
Everything okay, Eugene?
I want to report an assault.
Damn it, Gene. Are you talking about that punk again? Yeah, we had a call last night about a fight over at the car wash. You know, maybe that greaseball Louise didn't start it. You ever think about that?
Louise didn't start it. I did. Louise was jealous as all hell. I don't want anything to happen to him. To Louise. But I want it on record. Louise assaulted John first.
Okay, okay. We'll take care of it. So, where's John now? What? You sitting there telling me you don't know where he is?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, Gary.
I just got a phone call from Sheriff Pullman. He's over in the next county. They found the body of a female torn apart by coyotes over Pettenwall Lake. Well, they're still working on a positive ID, but if that turns out to be Kelly, I'm gonna be doing a whole lot more than talking to your friend.
Here.
Have you lost your mind?
Do you know whose house you're in? This is Visser's house.
Yeah, well, then I'll say hello, because I was with him this morning.
What?
Yeah. I hitched a ride. I gave him every opportunity to kill me, or fuck me, or whatever. And he took offense, John.
He took offense because he doesn't act on impulse like that. He stakes him out. He plans out every yummy detail.
Listen to me. I read the homicide files, okay?
Uh-huh.
They cut him loose for a reason.
Yeah, because they didn't have any idea who they were dealing with,
no.
Just like you.
No. They had no motives, no prints, no DNA,
yeah,
nothing.
Because he's too smart for that shit. He's too clever.
Okay, so what are you gonna get him on? What, the candlestick in the library?
I've got him convinced that I'm a killer, too. He's been teaching me. I've had to do things.
Oh my God.
I got him this close to telling me everything.
He's lying to
me. Maybe he's not lying to me, I'm lying to him. I'm playing this motherfucker.
He has a box of shit in his basement.
Baby.
It's a front, John, okay?
Uh-huh.
He's playing a part just like you.
You didn't hear. You didn't hear the way that he talked to me about everything that happened. The way that he talked about my father.
Your father was wrong.
Not about Visser. There's no way he was wrong because he gave up everything. He gave up his family and his career and his life.
And you.
Yeah, and me.
I can't watch you go down the same hole.
We can't do this right now. You gotta get out of here, okay? You have to go right now.
I asked you to teach me how to get away with it, and you never did
because you couldn't.
Because you never did. The watch trick. It wasn't yours. Kemper used it. Right here, there's a chapter on how to kill people in your head. The aura phase, right? And then right here, underlined and highlighted, the unguarded moment. That's exactly what you said to me. What'd you do? You just learned everything from these books and then you just puked it out at me? Like it was yours?
I told you who I was that night in the woods. But you wanted me to be this awful person, and I figured, who better? I've lived it.
It's because they said that it was you, and people believed it.
I believed it. And then I believed you.
No one has listened to me for a long time. I'd almost make it true. If you'd stay. I got a bad heart. Arthritis. Life's a gift from God, and I've wasted it. No good works, no kids. There was a lady I loved once back in Chicago, Sharon. I was going to adopt her son, Franklin. Man, oh man, did that kid love me. They handcuffed me right in front of them. I'll never forget how scared they were, their faces. The man who arrested me was so cruel. He didn't care I had a family. He didn't care a boy was going to be without a dad. When they let me go, I went to see her. She looked at me like I was a monster. I never saw them again. What I did to you, lying all this time, there's no excuse. There's no excuse. But if you please stay until after dinner tomorrow, you would surely make an old man's harvest day.
Yellow.
So you two playing house over there?
Don't have a clue what you're talking about.
Hardaway came snooping around yesterday. Wanna know if I talk to your boy.
What do you want, Luis?
Well, my last check.
And pain and suffering from my injuries, how about that?
Oh, okay. Come on by the shop, couple of 3 days and we'll...
Nah. Let's do this now, Gene.
I gotta go by the shop. See Luis.
Eugene, I think...
I won't be long.
Kidding me?
Hey, look at my fucking hand, man. Look at my fucking hand, Eugene. What's wrong with you, man? Kidding me, man? Get the fucking check. I'm back.
Mr. Van Winger?
Mm-hmm.
We met yesterday. You gave me a lift in your truck.
Oh, yeah. I'm really, really busy right now.
I know that I told you that I didn't know anyone in town.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm here to see John.
John. You guys know each other?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Well, I knew him a couple of times. And he told me to meet him here.
Here?
Yeah, I really need to speak with him. It's important.
Oh, okay, sure. Come on in.
So he's here?
Yeah. He's here. He's out back.
This was over, did you, John?
You've known all along who I was, right?
That about you being a serial killer. That was truly inspired. And that thing with Kelly in the tub, you might just be better at this than your old man. You may not believe me, son, but I never intended for him to go and shove that gun in his mouth. Tom stopped answering my calls, tried to go on living a normal life, whatever that is.
Talking about him.
Girl came around looking for you. Pretty thing. I told her not to panic, John. That's the key.
She stays calm. Well, you might find her.
Where is she?
You have all you need. 1 hour, maybe two. That seems fair.
All right, get the fuck up. Come on.
Oh, man, you have officially fucked yourself for life.
Give me your keys. Let's go, let's go.
Okay,
let's go,
okay,
let's go,
okay.
Let's go.
Okay, Eugene is not who you think he is. He's a serial killer named Francis Allen
Knock
Visser.
Knock off the stories.
He murders women. You know what? Look at this. This photo. That picture. He ever show you that? Look at that. He bought this photo.
He made it all up.
And he's starting again. Chief, he takes those girls and he buries them alive.
Is that what you did to Kelly?
You bury her alive?
No, I didn't bury her alive. I left Kelly in her car up by Highway 2 with...
When you're ready, you can drive out of this shit town and don't ever come back, okay?
Shit!
What are you doing in there?
Eugene! Thank God! That kid you've been hanging out with, he's got off the rails. He's talking about you burying people. Stop!
For you.
following in your daddy's footsteps.
Fuck you.
Shame the way that ended. Gotta give him credit. Real bulldog. Never let up.
You know, I got Hardaway in the car right now. He's got your fake family photos.
He knows you're
liar.
You think I'm going down for a couple postcards and some fairy tale?
What about Luis or Kelly?
Oh, Kelly. I had to follow the two of you all the way out there to finish that one off. And I gotta be honest, with a yummy ass like that girl had, whew, it was fun.
You gotta know you're not walking away from me.
Son, look at me, son. I'm an old man. I've always walked away. Oh, God. A lifetime
for
walking away. As long as there's nothing linking me to Luis, I'll walk right out of that police station just like I did with your daddy. You, on the other hand, you really should have been more careful. You're leaving puzzle pieces everywhere you go.
You did set me up.
Oh, and here you are, a smoking gun. I gave John an antique straight razor. Grace, the manager, saw you leave with Kelly. Careful with what you leave behind. You came here to bring me to justice. I'm not going to soft silver for you. You failed.
Just let her go.
No, I just don't think it's in my nature. But don't worry, it'll be over soon. And then you'll feel everything your daddy felt. To see somebody get out.
Fuck you.
Go get the chief.
Don't bother. He's had an unfortunate incident.
Maybe we can't pin Luis on you. But Audrey right here is a walking, talking piece of evidence that didn't stay in the box. And now we got the chief, too. And you know something? You lost, Eugene.
Well, now that's a matter of opinion.
Oh, really? Explain that to me.
Girl stays in the ground. Another notch. No big deal. But the day I'm caught is the day everybody learns the real scary truth. It's the guy next door, guy who sits too close in the theater, maybe even the church. Plain, ordinary, the everyday man. That's the guy they should be afraid of, because they never see him coming. It'll be quite a story. A son catches the killer who beat his dad, and right at the center of it all will be me. Frank Visser, me. I never lose, son. Never, ever.
What are you doing?
I'm calling it in. I can't listen to this shit anymore.
Wait. What if we didn't?
What do you mean?
I mean, what if we don't call it in?
We're cops. What are you saying?
That's what he wants. He wants us to arrest him and connect him to all those murders so he gets the fame and the credit and all that shit
so the whole world can see how fucking brilliant he is.
But the only way that doesn't happen
is if we bury him.
If we bury you and everything you've done.
You couldn't do it.
Oh, really? You're right, it won't be easy. It's all about adapting. It's what you've been doing this whole time, right? Well, I'm adapting. It's just a matter of being careful, being clean. Trust me, we won't rush. The hardest part's gonna be the chief, making that look like an accident.
But
I'll figure something out. We're gonna make sure the world never knows that Eugene Van Winger was once Francis Allen Visser.
You'll be the first one the cops call in.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure they'll work me for hours,
days even.
It doesn't matter. If they don't have the evidence, they can't hold me. Isn't that right? Isn't that what you taught me?
You'll never get away with it.
Maybe. Maybe not. But they'll never find out about you. They'll never know who you really were.
Maybe I'll think about you. On Thanksgiving, when I'm carving my turkey, maybe. Or when I shave. But no one else. No one will ever think of you, Eugene.
Never again. You'll be forgotten. Like it never fucking happened.
That's pretty good, isn't it? Yeah, I had a good teacher. You know, I got something else, though, that you never had. An alibi. Right, baby? What do you think? I can't do it on my own. You with me?
Better get started.
No. No! No! No!
You have all you need.
No!
1 hour, maybe two. That seems fair.